Hello. Welcome to the Honest Wargamer. I'm your host, Rob, for this incredibly exciting watch along a thong, joined by Mr. Val Heffelfinger. Hello, Val.
I can't wait for Cisco to show up for the watch along a thong song. It's going to be awesome.
Long, along, along.
We spent a lot of money on Cameo to make it happen, and I think you guys are really going to enjoy what Cisco's done for us tonight.
So if you are excited about the reveals from Adepticon, potentially the launch of Age of Sigmar 4, some spicy old world stuff, or any of those things, you are nowhere near as prepared as to watch till the very end of this video and this stream, where you will then also see a cameo from Cisco.
From Cisco.
And if some of you Zoomers...
Definitely something's happening.
Some of you Zoomers are too young to know... Cisco is kind of like a I don't even know who they would compare it. Cisco is your generation's Machine Gun
Kelly.
He's
like a dollar store Nelly.
Yeah.
but even Nelly's a little play. Maybe the kids might know
Nelly's like a dolly. Nelly's a dollar store someone else. Usher.
For sure. Yeah, there you go.
Okay, so listen, if you've never done a watch along a thong before on the Honest Wargamer TM.2.0, there's some amazing stuff which you've never seen. We've been doing these since before any of the other content creators out there have been doing it. It's a trend now. Everyone does it, but we're the OGs. And we have some big, spicy things that we like to go through. Let's quickly hit up a bunch of guesstimations. But also, if you are watching this along, watch along with us at home, okay? Because there's some things that we love to do. Number one, where are the presenters going to be? Now, this isn't as spicy as it used to be. They do have a specially designed studio and set. Really lovely studio, actually. Designed by the Rouge Hobbies herself. Most people don't know that. But all of the sets at Warhammer Palouse designed by Rouge Hobbies. She did some set design while she was there. Concepting.
Very good.
Pretty cool. So they have a fancy set. Although that may change. Val? What? Give me a spread bet. I don't know anything about betting, so you're gonna laugh at the words I use. What's the chance?
Fine.
What's the? Give me an under over even split bet on what you think the likelihood we're gonna see something in situ at Adepticon.
Are we gonna be live from the scene? I'm gonna say plus 7,000 chance.
Okay.
That we're actually gonna see live on location Adepticon today. Also, okay. this just in, breaking. Cisco will in fact do a cameo for $240 Canadian dollars, or will respond to our message for $4. So by the end of this, if we raise enough, we might be able to follow through on our bit from earlier in the show.
Hit that donation tab right now. Okay, hit that donation tab. We could have Cisco on the stream. That's so cheap. What happened?
It's not a lot. I mean, $4 just to get a message from him. I mean, why wouldn't we do that?
I honestly think for $4, it's not him. It's a team that do it. A team is strong. A guy.
If a celebrity's on Cameo, do they have a team?
That's a great point. I don't know. Okay, so...
We're recording right now. Sorry,
yeah, well,
I didn't mean to derail this.
No, I'm part of the derailing. I'm generally focusing on a track. So the follow-up to where it's going to be, I think we're just going to see it from the studio. Very controllable space, but Adepticon's obviously a big hitter. Follow-up, who is going to be presenting? Now, again, long-time fans of the show who've watched a watch along a thong before. We've had some really great times. Let's never forget Adam Troke's bedroom. That's great. Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Very active space for streaming. So who do you think we're going to see? Don't forget the famous Adepticon. Was it Adepticon or LVO? I think it was Nova last year where we saw Eddie absolutely
dominate the space and push
Mike out
Alfred.
Of the physical. Alfred him out. Yeah. Like Holy green Alfred. Line, red line.
I don't even know if Mike was still in the shot by the end of that one. Eddie just fully taking up the entire space. I mean, Eddie does seem to have a pretty big hit streak. What about the now? If we're back in the studio, if we're live from Warhammer HQ,
yeah,
it might be the their Didn't they hire like someone who doesn't actually care about Warhammer to do that kind of stuff?
Yeah, so they had
kind of look like a deer in the headlights.
Yeah, so they previously, so like for a long time, Eddie's actually interestingly moved jobs. He tweeted about it the other week. Not sure we'll even see him as a presenter. So that's the real big question.
Did he get promoted to Bugman's?
I don't know where he's gone. I think he's gone over into IP following the rest of the team for the movies. He's moving into movies. Yeah,
uh-huh.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Which I assume is him just presenting Warhammer streams in the movie. That's what I can. hope for.
It's just a stream from his bedroom about what he'd like to see in a Warhammer movie.
Yeah. But so Eddie, I think we'll see Eddie because really, who else do they have? Don't forget Games Workshop. They did hire a new presenter, but he was previously an actor, and as I understand it, doesn't have any like knowledge inside of the space, and so he's learning them as he goes. Which, you know, we love a new hobbyist. That's great. Would I get a new? You're a media professional.
Certainly.
Would you hire? What would you hire? Would you hire a best fit? No, zero information, but pretty charming. Or would you go for not as charming, but knows everything? What would be your? What's your port of call here?
Well, I mean, if I was a type of a organization that was able to invest in, say, I don't know, prep notes. Or some sort of scripting, then obviously you could go with the actor quite comfortably and have an excellent presenter delivering the informed information. Because I don't know if you know this, Rob, but when someone is broadcasting the news, they don't actually know any of those things. They're just reading them off of a screen. So, I mean, you could, in theory, do that and thus make this a smart call. Go with the person with the gravitas, with the panache, with the presentation skills. Unfortunately, they don't have a teleprompter or someone to fill it with words, so I don't know if it was the right way to go necessarily.
They do have one of them like reels of paper that they can just circle really fast,
even a Sharpie and some Bristol board like they do on all the talk shows. I don't know why they still do that on the talk shows.
I think it's just part. Like, I think it's some crowd work.
Maybe it's a bit.
I think it's
a bit.
Like this, a bit. This is all a bit.
All a bit.
All right, so you're thinking, I'm thinking Eddie and the new guy. You're going Eddie and the new guy presentation or spicy take, third person in the room?
Three-person booth.
It's a wild choice. I'm not sure. Messes the symmetry up massively.
Now, I'm trying to think. LVO, they did this from the studio, right? They didn't do this live on location. So this also, someone's got to be able to wake up at 2 o'clock in the morning back at HQ. And do this. What if someone slept in, Rob, and you get the call? Would you dust off the old headset and just hop in on the preview?
No.
Just grab your old black T-shirt. Shave off the sides of your hair.
I'm not going back. I'm not doing this. I'm not doing it. I remember when we launched 8th edition 40K. I'm not doing it anymore. I refuse. So then,
You must have.
I launched 8th edition 40K for Games Workshop, just a little credo my media, and I did a 24-hour stream.
Yeah.
There was an author, I forget his name because I blanked it out, 17 hours into the stream. This is a war story for everyone. And I was like, so, you've written a new book about orcs. Obviously, this incredible battle between, I forget the guy that fights orcs. He's dead now, that guy.
Yarrick.
Yeah. Wow. And he's like, you've written a story about them. How do you feel about it? He's like, yeah, I like the book. Okay, so what? Like, it was like drawing teeth. I shut the interview down like 11 minutes in. He gave me nothing. Like a stone. Like he was contractually obligated to give some answers, but that's it. I was like, I'm 17 hours in, brother. Help me out, but nothing. Anyway, so we don't know who the presenters are yet. That's exciting. Then we don't know what the space is. And again, if you're like, this isn't a big deal, lads. It is. At one point, it could have been from someone's bedroom with some random jockey. We had no idea. So it's got professional now. Let's be serious.
Professionalized. These people are working with Amazon at this point. So
exactly. Okay.
Can't have asked that.
Big deal. So then the follow-up is the classic. How many books and how many miniatures are we going to see revealed? Oh, I did kind of side skip what we're going to see as outfits. I'm going pure check shirts. But check shirt on Eddie. and I'm going for kind of like, this won't make much sense to non-English people, but like a Jamie Oliver two up, two down, new build T-shirt for the actor guy. That makes sense to English people. That makes sense.
Two up, two down. I want a T-shirt that's described as a two up, two down. that'd be pretty sweet if I got to that point in my life. So, I mean, you threw a lot at me there, but let me just, I mean, quickly,
books
just take a quick peek. I just got to take a quick peek here to see what's in the lineup.
Okay.
I got to go to the old Warcom.
We can do that.
Dislike it.
So if no one knows what we're talking about, if no one knows what we're talking about, this is a bit of a competition we can play inside of the Twitch chat and you can follow along at home. How many books are we going to see revealed? How many miniatures are we going to see revealed? It's pretty interesting. It's pretty interesting, and we can go through
individual minis for the potential Age of Sigmar box set. Although we're probably not going to see a box set today, are we?
We're not going to see the box set. I think you're absolutely right. We should actually look at like what is the where's the link to the? I need the which things we're seeing done here. I can't remember where the link is. It's somewhere.
We've got exciting teasers for Necromunda and Warhammer the Horus Heresy. Well, that's lovely.
Okay,
all right, we got Warhammer 40K. So we've already done Tau. I have no idea what's coming. Oh, actual orcs are coming.
Orcs are coming for Warhammer 40K.
Yeah.
Okay. So what are you saying? Codex and some minis. Give me a number. You just got to guess.
I'm just rapid fire here. I'm going to say. No, man, there's always like a box set of something. I don't know. Cool dozen Warhammer 40,000 minis.
This is a huge deal to both me and Val because we're both huge orc stands. So I'm gonna say just book one mini character mini.
One
That's
mini.
It.
For the 40K reveal at Adepticon, I mean, there's got to be something cool to do there.
Okay.
Warhammer Age of Sigmar. I mean, if they're just teasing the return of the 4.0 here, then we may not really see any minis or even they will imply a book. I'm going to say no minis.
No minis. I'm going with you. No minis. We're going to see the launch trailer.
Do we count like shadows and like shadowy spinny?
No,
minis
that's not
minis?
A mini. That's not a mini.
Not a
that's
mini.
That's a silhouette.
Okay. Warcry, I'm going to go with 24. I'm going to go two teams of whatever Warcry things
are.
Oh,
yeah. New Warcry box. I agree. Book. There's no book there. Age of Sigmar is a huge deal. Like I know Val, we're both square bast as we can be for the old world.
As bast can be.
You're gonna see a dwarf book announcement, maybe a solo dwarf mini. Okay, but
that's what I'm thinking. I don't even know if we'll see a book. I think we're seeing a book. I think we'll see the dwarf mini. I don't think we'll see much else.
We need to pivot back to Age of Sigmar. Age of Sigmar 4th edition announcement. This is the actual showstopper. I don't think this is necessarily the play order. I think Age of Sigmar we hit mid to last because this is maybe even first. It's the big. This is the sellout ticket today. This is the star. This is who they should be doting all of their affection on. They've already cancelled Warhammer Fest this year, so the absolutely thrilling job that they did last year for Warhammer 40,000, where you could queue for 4 hours and play for 8 minutes, won't be available for Age of Sigmar this year. But so this is their one opportunity for be like, yo, it's Sigmar, so it's big. We should focus on that, I think. But oh well,
so this is you might say that this is their moment. They own it. They better not let it go.
I swear to God, if that ends up being a Cisco line,
well, it was a mangled M&M line. Everybody,
oh that's fine.
My millennial continues to show. All right, look, I'm going to say. That, we're not saying a lot for Warhammer the Old World. I know that you're saying the Warhammer Age of Sigmar is the showstopper, which means that it'll probably feature somewhere between Necromunda and Warcry, because, you know, that's the pride of place that it should get. Remember that epic fake out we got where they, wow. Anyway, previous reveal shows have left us wanting, we're going to see maybe a launch trailer, but I don't know if we'll see any hints of minis.
I don't think any minis. I'm just going to jump to Necromunda if you don't mind. We'll skip Underworld. Who cares? Necromunda, but lovely that they put it there. Necromunda, I think we're seeing, get ready for it, a new edition.
It's like a whole new thing, isn't there? There's a whole new edition.
This is actually a big deal. Big deal. So two new editions could be announced at Adepticon this year. It's pretty spicy. And then we got which I'm unsure, but I think we'll see minis. I think we're going to see minis from that. I'm going to say a book, a box, and some and 10 minis, Necromunda. Book box minis.
Now, those are teasers, though. Like, so we're going to go over. I'm just saying that we might see the lowest mini and book total of all time in this particular lineup, right?
Interesting. You're saying book, because at one point, the reason we do books and minis as a guess is there were zero minis and only books. And then, hilariously, at the Black Library reveal stream, there was only minis and only two books.
That's funny.
So let us know, chat, what you think it is. We're gonna try and grab it now. Grab the stream. So you're thinking a very low number of books. Just give me a number. Just guess a book. Let's go.
I'm gonna say 7 books. A total of 37 minis.
Okay. As everyone can see, I am banned from the chat.
Very nice.
Long-term
I like
fans.
That it tells you that you are banned. Like it's not soft about it. Mm-hmm. It's like no, you like the reason you can't access this is that they don't want you here
on a channel that I made, and also with an.
Look at this! You got a reveal here.
What? No, this what?
Looks like we're into it.
We're already in.
Yeah, it's 11:01. They're coming out swinging.
Whoa. Hold on, I need to turn all their audio off. What? Woo! Okay. Chaos Lord, Legionnaires? What? Wait, hold on. No, are you sure this is a reveal?
I mean...
No, this isn't a reveal. This isn't a reveal.
Something's happening.
Death of the False Emperor. Find out more. No, this is just a trailer, I think. These are all old kits, new sculpts. Oh my god, you were not expecting this, chat. You were not expecting this. It's Nick and Simon. Wait, who are these two guys? Oh, wait, that's the guy. What's his name?
Oh, it's a four-bagger! It's a four-bagger!
It's a four-bagger!
We got a four-way!
I think this is a trailer. Wait, hold on. I could listen to it. Hold on.
If only we're basically like Games Workshop casters right now. But we're not having any audio. We don't even have a table boss telling us what's on the screen.
So we missed the beginning. That's audio. Great. I can't believe we missed the beginning. I'm gutted. I can't believe chat made us just... What do you...
they started incredibly on time.
Huh? They did. Oh, wait, I forgot to press play. Kind of shit. Collection.
Yeah, you should probably do that. If you want to go all in and get both... Oh, we're, start, so I we're think, going I think, all the way back?
How do you mean? Cool. Now, of
course, well, where'd the four guys go?
The four guys are there. Okay.
Okay.
All right. The four guys are there. So you've got, wow, a lot of crotch in this particular scene. I'd have had a conversation with the videographer and I'd said, lads, like, let's get some upper torso.
Is this our cropping or is this their framing?
That's their framing. That's their framing.
It feels like they're in a very low-ceilinged room right now. There we go. That's a bit better.
It's very unfortunate. Like, presentation, lads. Like, dress for the job you want.
This is a common thing I notice this in talk shows all the time these days. Slouchy chairs in a talk show situation. Not a great fit, especially for, spineless middle-aged males. Who are melting into a puddle like I am at all times. You want like maybe a bar stool minimum. That's the most you want to trust.
It's winter here. It's winter here. Why are there shorts on my screen? Like, well, I'm uncomfortable.
They've got a lot of warm yellows, so they thought maybe they wouldn't look as translucent with the lighting. Good job on the lighting effects. I have to say.
I gotta say that
who are these people? Who is guy in striped shirt?
Guy in striped shirt, I do not know, but guy on the right is the head of 40K, Stu Black. You may have heard him from such incredible updates as all of 40K, and that's who Stu Black is. On the left-hand side, you have Simon, previously who worked for Stu. This is a bit of a spicy bit of info. Previously worked for Stu as a rules writer and then moved on, so could potentially be some friction there. And as you can see in the middle... A lot of sexual friction coming from the old drummer from Damascus, Nick Payton. He was in
Nick Payton really leaning in there. I like the open body language. I like that.
From everyone else, I don't think his is open. It's very forward.
Well, I'm forward to one man in particular, stripy shirt. Mystery stripy shirt here. Look at that.
Mystery Stripe Shirt.
Very leaned in.
Yeah, yeah. Mystery Stripe Shirt loves the Fit and Fresh podcast. You can just tell. Loves it.
Would love to know who that is.
don't worry. Don't worry about it. Like, you don't need to know. Okay.
All right, so these are previously, like, these are previously released minis.
Okay, perfect.
I'm tempted. I'm going to do something really, really strange. I'm going to turn this on in the background for myself, just so I have just a clue as to what the hell they're talking about.
Can you pan down, Rob? Not enough crotch on the other Swole Gamer. I'll try harder. Well, I think there's a new Chaos Lord coming out and a new Demon Prince coming out is maybe what we're seeing.
I think there was a big deal that I saw a rumor of
a dark commune. Go on.
Some sort of Chaos Lord with Jump Pack, which was a big deal. Holy crap! There are a lot of these. I can't find the actual thing. There's so many imposter watch-alongs.
You can't find.
You guys think you're watch-alongathons? Ah, here we go. The one with 22,000 viewers.
So this
That's
is what
the one.
This is what the 40K reveal is. A Chaos Lord. They're spending a lot of time on just talking about a Chaos Lord. If this is what they're doing, the dark.
Toss a Chaos Lord out there and not talk about it for 15 minutes.
Yeah.
Absurd.
This feels like it's a lot, is all I'm going to say for one Chaos Lord. New Codex as well. Okay. So that's the release so far. Oh, God. That's so in the camera, isn't it? It's so in the camera.
There we go.
Yeah.
All right.
They're talking about the Codex too. I would never want to listen. I told you. This is what Jamie Oliver and a new build looks like, if you ever want to know, Val. That outfit, right? That's a Zara fit. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Oh shit. Here we go. It's a new Eidneth. Okay, this is pretty spicy. Says Warcry. Okay. Could be our double box, like you were saying. A new Warcry box set. Val, you called it. 10 points for you. Shit, new Osart Bone Reapers, okay, versus new Eidoneth, no, Sylvaneth, new Sylvaneth, oh, they look amazing. Well, have we got some bees, oh, we got some new Bone Reaper buddies, we got Bone Reaper dogs.
I like the little dogs.
Cutification of Warhammer continues. Oh, the dogs, what do you think? This is good, this is a fun box set.
Nature and Nightmares. Briar and Bone.
Okay. This is interesting. So previously... we haven't talked about this, but it's all
pre-recorded.
Nick. Oh, okay. All right. If you can
all
just...
pre-recorded is what it is.
This is literally heaven and hell in an image. This is John Bracken. I got to shout out John Bracken. John Bracken's one of the loveliest, sweetest, greatest human beings on fucking earth. Absolutely adore him. Great sweater. Great sweat. I love John Bracken to pieces. And one of the things I like most about John Bracken is once when we were streaming for Games Workshop doing the 40K coverage, he said if ever he had to do a job that also included Nick Baton again, he'd quit. So this is a beautiful moment.
This is the swan song.
Yeah.
He's gonna kick over the IKEA cabinet in front of him. Peace out at the end of this.
I love John. Shout out John if you're watching this back. John hates Nick, right? And I'm going to say it for him, yeah? Because Nick's awful, right? I'm going to say it for him. But John is one of the rules writers. He went from the events team to become a rules writer, which is
pretty
special.
Seems legit.
Yeah. He's great. He loves Warhammer in his bones. You know, people who love it in their bones. He's a lifer. And he's just committed to making good
games. The type
of
guy, if you're walking down the street, he walks by you, you think to yourself, that guy loves Warhammer.
That's John Bracken, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Mm-hmm. That's John Bracken. Mm-hmm. I love him to pieces. Looks like he's doing really well. He's got a great outfit. He's from Ireland.
Quite animated.
Very animated. I'm not listening. And also, okay, it's taken a long time to get to the minis. This is pre-recorded. This is a pre-recorded video that they've uploaded, obviously.
Yes. Is that a new approach?
This is a brand new approach.
They've discovered that you could do live via videotape.
Yeah, this is a huge new thing. Like, big deal. So,
what, you mean we don't have to wake up at 2 in the morning?
And show some images.
We could just record it, like, in advance.
Yeah. Again, the shot is... Okay, let's look at the minis. The half centaur, fans of the show will know I'm a big... I'm very centaur-coded. Shout out to all
centaur.
The centaur ladies in the
bony
chat.
Centaur.
This is a bony centaur. What do you think about that? That's so good.
I like his bone whip. And also his pleasant loincloth there, allowing us to not have to wonder about the placement of his genitalia. That's very good.
I don't know about you, but I feel like this camera is directly featuring John's crotch. Like,
I mean, if they had the targeting reticle that you can like call up on a screen when you're like lining up your DSLR, they would have seen that they should have angled up a little bit, or maybe get a taller tripod. Who are we kidding? It's not on a tripod. Maybe it's just on a desk nearby. Maybe add some more books underneath it. There you go. This is
a lot.
A little tight. Very tight.
Sir, I'd like to call a manager. Okay, I think the Boom Reapers look great. I'm going to give them a solid 8 to 9 out of 10. They're getting on the weird side. I love getting weird. They've got bone dogs. They've got bone centaurs. That's pretty cool. That's really going to change the silhouette of OCR Bone Reapers as a range, which I love. And now we're going into... Go on.
I totally failed to notice the other half of this range when they first revealed it. But it's the Briar Patch or whatever.
The Pumpkin Patch Kits. That's who they're up against. Pumpkin Patch Kits. Yeah. These are great. Whoa, how many minis are in this set? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So if you don't know, Warcry Warbands can be used in Age of Sigmar. So this will be able to be used in a Sylvaneth army as a unit. Some of them are very popular. This looks great. It's got like a whole bunch of different weapons. They're really, really like little fun. So like, I don't know if kill teams are that usable in 40K, but the Warcry Warbands sometimes feature heavily in Age of Sigmar armies and are really excellent. And normally they're reinforceable, which means you can take multiples, which is pretty spicy.
That's sweet. I also want to shout out all of the people in the actual Warhammer TV chat right now, completely oblivious to the fact that there is no one actually there, that they're just watching a recording.
Honestly, if you're in the Games Workshop stream chat, you probably already there's a lot of lead poisoning in your area, is what I reckon. That's what I think.
They did not heed the boil order for their tap water, that's for sure.
No, they did not. The model shots are really dark, I will say that. Listen, compared to lifting a box from underneath your desk in your bedroom, it's gone a long way, okay? And, oh, look at the mini shots there. We got some mini shots. It's cinematic is what it is. Maybe
they've got one of those LED dolly camera things.
Yeah,
you can
slider.
Buy on the Amazon.
Slider.
Maybe their partnership with Amazon meant that they got like a nice solid 10% discount on stuff, and so they started buying some, low quality camera gear They had one slider
while I was there. I had to bring my own in for some of the filming. these are great. Look at this though. Like this guy's got
like
a
spinny slider on that.
Oh, this is fantastic. These look great. Okay. I'm going to give this a 10 out of 10. Solid. Like, I like what they're doing with this. So one of my predictions for Age of Sigmar 4 or maybe Age of Sigmar 5 in the future is they're going to split a lot of the ranges between light and dark. And there's already like, okay, Sylvaneth already have like a dark range in Dreitcha, because Dreitcha...
Good versus evil, if you will.
Oh, yes. Yes. Good versus evil. Famously done in Old World. But then that becomes a little bit awkward. So we might be seeing like the push towards dark Sylvaneth, but not dark as in like pure evil, more not the happy-go-lucky Alariel hippie fest, effectively.
Got it.
That's a fun little design cue. Love that. Could go somewhere with that. Not sure where. What do you think about this release? Good minis?
Fine. I mean, not really sparking joy in me, but that's okay. I'm not a big Bone Reaper guy.
Okay,
and the Sylvaneth, my favorite thing is definitely Lariel's thighs. So that wasn't featured here, and that's all I've got.
I got to say, I am not listening to it right now, but if I'm hearing the designers talk about what's actually going on as part of the presentation, this is a massive step up. Absolutely huge. This is exactly what I've wanted and advocated for. I'd like it to be, I love John. John's the best. I'd love more than just John, though. I'd love like Sculptor to have 5 minutes talking about what they're doing. You know, Painter talking about elements that they like. But this is a big deal. I don't think you even need them talking to someone, although I guess it brings a conversational tone as part of it. Like, this is pretty good. I like that.
Do you think that for the Old World presentation, we might actually see in the flesh JTY and other Danny?
We may well see that. We may well see that. So are we going to get weird studio? Oh, here we go.
Oh, he really leaned into the camera for that transition.
He did. It was uncomfortable. I'm just going to say that. Like, I felt violated. Okay, so this is Underworlds. This is a game no one in the world plays.
But now we're talking.
But they keep releasing great minis. Okay. Absolutely stunning.
Like, ooh, that is wild.
That is so good. Wow.
All right. Yeah, these guys are nuts.
Is this Flesh Eater Quartz versus New Cities models, but they've gone like flagellants? This is nuts. Wow. Okay, stop showing me the cards. No one cares. Literally,
isn't
no one
what do they call that? Oh, like a famous torture device.
The Jibbity Sprocket.
It's an Iron Maiden. Yeah. An Iron Maiden.
That's it. That's it. The band. That's what torture is, listening to Iron Maiden. Okay, just show me the minis. Show me the minis. Oh, God.
No, nope. Nick Baden.
Show me the minis. Oh, John's back. Let's go, John.
He's back.
John didn't quit after round one, was like, fuck it, I'll do round two. Yeah, I'm in. I've committed. Go on, John. okay, just show us some minis, please. This is all I actually want to see.
I mean, sweater's still nice, so I'm in.
It looks very comfortable. I don't know where he gets them from, but he's had them for years. Like, very comfortable, very, very, like, the dipped neck thing has always been a feature of his outfits. And I just don't know where you buy that. What do you Google for? It's not a ruff.
Like a shawl. It's not really a shawl collar.
What is that?
What is that? It's called very Robin Hoodish.
Potentially.
Potentially. All right. Let's. Nick did get a nice new haircut for this though. Nice, fresh. The Nottingham barbershop.
Maybe there were discounts at the church that day. Who knows?
Very happy to see him. Tighten that fade up, Nick. Oh, here's some minis.
Please show me some minis. Please show me the minis in detail. You're incredibly...
They are showing... There we go.
Okay, wow. Yeah, so the guy in the Iron Maiden... Okay, just slow down. Oh, my God.
That was a bit quick. That was a bit quick, guys.
Okay. All right. That's a bit quick, I think. What does everyone think? I would like everyone's reaction to this. Just more react to the stream production stream.
Someone in the Warhammer chat just typed, "Yawn, next announcement, please."
Yawn!
Again, no one's actually there.
I like that they would just be like, oh, shit,
Notley points out to this person, it's pre-recorded. That was an excellent interaction that I just happened to observe.
Okay, here we go. Minis. Okay, new Flesh Eater Quartz. Okay. Ooh, fresh off.
The
fresh
fork jammed into the bone there was kind of gross. That kind of made my stomach lurch.
Oh, these are fun. Okay, these are fun. They're very cool.
I mean, they're cool, but like the tuning fork in the, what do you call that? Not a fibula. What's your forearm bone called? Anyway.
Arm bone.
Arm.
I think
like
arm
a, it was like a... jammed into the arm bone.
That's a bit much. I think the cities guys. I don't like the cities guy going a bit weird. I don't want no Vindicar. Like all the cities of Sigmar guys hate Vindicarum. None of us are pro Vindicarum guys. Oh, here we go.
Don't get me started on Vindicarum,
dude. Right, he's got a poker. That's fun. Oh, the fully beefed up guy is great.
What is going on with that device? Was it electrical?
No,
it's a strange device.
Everyone thought that this was a new new Stormcast mini, but it's not. It's a weird. That is weird. That's great.
That is good weird. See, these guys on both sides of the squad here more evocative to me than the Warcry minis. I like them a lot.
The Warcry minis. I think I'm just going to say it now. No disrespect. Shout out to the team. The Warcry minis were terribly lit. I barely could see them.
Yeah, you might say it was unlit.
Shout out to the Zoomers.
Opposite of lit. These guys are like electrical. They're like juiced up with the power of Sigmar.
Yeah, Sigmar's a lightning god with blonde hair who lives in heaven and calls down his thunder warriors to battle against evil.
How oily are the thunder warriors? Because I'm a...
They're
you're catching my interest here. Just lost oily. 20 people just stopped watching when I asked how oily the Thunder Warriors were. It's fantastic.
Yeah, he's not Zeus and he's not Thor. I need you to know that. He's none of those things. Okay. I really wish that we would see more of the minis. That's why I'm gonna.
No, I like just a wide shot of two guys talking over a board game. I think that's pretty scintillating. I don't mind it one bit.
I don't mind the panning art. The art's great.
That's good.
I like that they're still committing to this game, even though I think they know it's dead. Like, it's just out.
So do you think no one plays it? Like, is it just like one of those things where we don't know anyone who plays this, therefore no one plays it?
It's big in Sweden.
I mean, surely the Facebook group is lit.
Potentially. I think it's big in Sweden. I don't know where else it gets played.
Big in Sweden.
Yeah. A lot of people think it's really fun. Got Mike in the chat saying, someone else, Okpanda, it's a great game. Okpanda has been the only person who has said that in the chat so far. So, chat, give me a who's playing Underworld right now. Roll call. Let me know. Again, YouTube.
We got a Warhammer Underworlds community, private, 11,000 members, 6 posts a day.
How active is that?
Not really popping. Maybe they're on Discord. Maybe they're on Discord.
Okay. All right. Okay. Okay, so I think a lot of people in the chat not. Oh, so we got a second one in the chat who loves it. Okay, 2 people in the chat. It's pretty big.
That's look, pretty big. I played it at one point when it was Shadespire. we got
this,
something.
This shot of this of the Love Island guy in the chair is sending me. What are we doing here? What? whose fanfic is this man in? Okay.
He just teased something bigger happening for Age of Sigmar later.
Yeah. So this is going to be our 6th book in the kind of wrap-up narrative. Okay.
This is a book.
Bro. Well, it's going to be mini-release as well. It's a mini-release as well because it's going to be like some characters. Oh, my God. We've just got
new
Chaos Lord.
On the right, isn't it?
New Chaos Lord and Demonic Mount. Okay. Their Darkest Day.
Darkest Day.
Perfect. Okay, who are they going to call in? My shout is Ben J. Oh, no, we didn't. We've swapped it up. We've got Nick and Simon now. Okay, so, we haven't. We've got Phil to dial it up to 11.
Oh, look at that.
Can I get some dial it ups to 11 in the chat, please? Phil's famous catchphrase is that we like to dial it up to 11, and he does it every time. So, Age of Sigmar 1 and 2, dial up to 11, dial up to 11
Can we just call out that they've totally changed up the furniture for this scene?
It's a completely different scene.
We got new chairs. We got a couch.
Yep. That's Matt Rose. He's the head of the balance team. Stole our stats once. I forgive you, Matt. Not really, but still.
Oh, lovely. Shout out, Matt.
Shout out, Matt. Thief. And then here you can see, delightful. This is an amazing mini. This is great.
He's cool as hell. He's mean. He's demonic. He's got some gilded armor. He's on some sort of a beast. What is that?
Phil is, someone in the chat says, tell us Phil is a dick. Phil is not a dick. Phil is a babe. And like me, he loves Babylon 5. So he's just a great person. Great mini.
Is that just, I mean, it's perfect.
What's not to
Lizard-like?
Love?
Like?
It looks like it's
going to... A lot of gold trim.
Yes. Yeah, although I'm currently painting specifically that Slaves to Darkness range for the old world. And I'm just not painting the trim.
I mean, that's one way to handle it.
Just not doing it. I'm just not doing it. Oh my God, I swear, if you see Phil's hand move where it looks like he's turning a dial, that means he's turning that whole thing up to 11.
Crank it right up to 11. Just go right past 10, folks.
Straight past every time. That's fun. Interestingly, Matt is a hire. Used to work in the computer games industry in the balancing for some computer games, and he's brought that acumen over to the balance team in Age of Sigmar. That's what you're seeing from him. The shot of the two lads just smiling is great. Although, while the set is different, Simon's still in the shorts, not messing around.
This guy, he doesn't want to be hot on set. I would also like to just shout out Phil's incredibly relaxed body language and posture here. Mm-hmm. This is a guy who's been here before. He's done fluff pieces about new releases for years. Going back to the original YouTube channel Games Workshop released, then lost the password for and is just trapped forever in amber on the internet. Really strong recommend that you go check out the Games Workshop Studio YouTube channel. Fantastic stuff, folks. Anyway, he's looking good. His co-pilot, though, a little leaned up, a little tight.
Matt's
maybe
serious.
Not used to being on camera like this.
Oh, Matt does the MetaWatch videos every time. Matt's a presenter at heart. He loves a bit. Look, he's got a cheeky smile. He loves the limelight. Like, I'm going to be honest, maybe not all the way, but he doesn't mind people.
Probably more of a desk guy, though. He probably would have liked to see a desk, direct to camera address, maybe a camera one, camera two situation, this open concept thing, not setting him at ease. Neither is Nick Boynton's slack-jawed gaze at him.
But you're right.
Disconcerting for the best of us.
Phil's energy is huge. Phil's energy.
Oh, okay. We got a very leaned-in transition again. Throw to a new reveal. It's just Phil Kelly again.
It's another, but with a different haircut. And then this is our new Dawnbringers book, the last book in the series to round us off before the Age of Sigmar 4 reveal. If anyone wants to quickly get an update on what's been happening, over the series of books, two different crusades have been marching through the realms of Age of Sigmar, attempting to reclaim some different parts of the land. And different character dramatis personae have been popping in, and some have been on the good guy side, some have been on the bad guy side, some have been, you know, just their own frenzied, eating their own hand self, and then having a good time. And then we're now at the final book in the series. So the previous one, launching into Age of Sigmar 3, was called Broken Realms. This is the Dawnbringer Crusade, is what we're on. And then this will somehow emerge with Skaven at the end. Not sure how, but it will.
Cities of Sigmar looks so good.
Yeah.
Cities of Sigmar looks really good.
Really good. That Chaos Lord on Demonic Mount is stunning, right?
That's a demonic mount, is what we're calling this. Very nice.
Oh, do you think he'll be a demonic mount?
I'm not sure. I was curious to know what it would be.
I think he might be.
It's just like looks like a big lizard guy with horns.
Interestingly, for fans of RPGs, Soulbound, which is an Age of Sigmar RPG, have just released a bestiary for Age of Sigmar, which has just been released, which is cool. So
lovely.
If you're excited about looking at some like bestiary stuff, this is quite fun.
I like that they're supporting Age of Sigmar with an RPG. That's a key part of what makes the old world so fleshed out, is really all the stuff they did in the RPGs.
And similarly true for Age of Sigmar, the Cubicle 7 do the RPG, and they do a ton of work on this, which is fun. So there's loads of backstory now from this. So we got, oh, hello, that's new art. That is a new art of a Dark Oath guy. We're still awaiting the new FOMO box, which is all the Dark Oath minis. Oh, this would be a great video to watch back. I love Phil talking about this stuff. These have been shown before, but these are pre-released Dark Oath miniatures. Yeah, they're so cute. They're just one.
They have a very different design style now for humans, I'm noticing. Like, their features are very different. This is going to sound dumb, but they're not realistic. Like, they have like almost cartoonish features.
So I would actually argue that the Dark Oath stuff looks really real, and then the Dark Oath stuff looks really real and like very like more true to life, like you were saying. Whereas the city stuff is intentionally aesthetically pudding like. Again, English reference, but they look very Greg's coded. That makes a lot of sense, I guess. To you, they look very Timmy's coded, like the more realistic.
Yeah, I did notice that the cities of Sigmar were better fed than you would think for a displaced people in a realm gate. They do seem to be getting their grains, which is good.
Yeah, it's very, very good. Oh, here they're talking about Age of Sigmar 1 and or the Age of Sigmar. I think it's still Age of Sigmar 1, not Age of Sigmar 0. But yeah, this is going to be, I should go, but I think it's Age of Sigmar 1. And it's the original launch box, which is 10 years old now. So this is going to be a pretty it's going to be a big update. It's very exciting. I think this is Phil just talking it through, leading up to the change. I do wonder, now you're a marketing guy. Yeah, someone who comes up with Watch Along a Thong is a marketing guy.
I mean, the whole town's talking.
So simple.
Trending on X.
Simple and not simple for 40K. Age of Sigmar, what's your catchphrase? New, not newer.
Morbidly complex.
Morbidly complex.
They're going to have twice as many characteristics. They're gonna have multiple sided dice. We're going like D20s or like rolls to hit. It's gonna get just incredibly arcade. You're gonna need an abacus. There's gonna be like a GW made abacus. It's gonna be amazing.
I love that. I love Tommy Potters is in the chat. This is good. HTML 4, sillier, not silly. I would buy that. I'd be like, wait, sillier but not silly. Come in. Yeah. I don't want to be too silly.
That's a pretty good catchphrase for Games Workshop output in general.
What, sillier, not silly?
It's silly, not silly. Okay. Oh, look at those mega gargants. Can't wait to use one of those as a bone grinder.
Oh, baby. Right.
It'll be fun.
Yeah. Oh, that's new. That is a brand new thing we're seeing. We just saw a brand new thing.
Or is that an old thing?
No, it's a brand new thing. That looked like a chaos fountain. So the way that you found a city of Sigmar is you locate a nexus of power, and then they build kind of like a siphon that they stick on top of it. That thing that they just showed there looked like someone building like a corrupted siphon on top of a nexus of power. Oh, they brought someone new in. Alex. Oh, they're rolling the cast out. Oh, my God. Okay, it's a deep dive with Alex.
Bill Kelly has just outlasted 4 co-hosts. Okay? Bill Kelly's still going. They've had to bring in guys in shifts to be able to take, like, just to handle this guy's energy right now.
It's a deep dive by Phil Kelly. Phil sat down, he's like, it's deep dive. Yeah. He wouldn't move. Shout out to Alex's barber. I know you've been looking at all the different haircuts, but Alex's barber created what I can only describe as an absolutely perfect haircut. Not a single hair out of place.
Look at that. Look at that. It's beautiful. It's perfect.
That's perfect. He looks stunning.
Could be stunning. Are you familiar with Kids in the Hall?
No, sir.
Oh, wow. Okay. Very, very proud and famous Canadian sketch comedy troupe. Reminiscent of a character known as Cabbage Head. Bit mean, but nonetheless true.
I gotta say, I think Alex has put together perfectly. Alex, you're doing great, son. This is a new set design. What I like is that they have the very expensive set that they set up, and then the very cheap chairs that they brought in from another part of the business, which are not quite as good for the job.
Those are different than the other chairs. Perhaps people were complaining about the slouchiness of them, or perhaps Nick Boynton just leaned too far into the camera, wiped out. They didn't have a match set anymore. They had to bring in something else.
Yeah, it's a very interesting time on set. I think they're still. This will be. Do you know what? I'm going to say it right now. I'm a little mad I'm not listening to Phil talk about the stuff. I'm going to go, this is genuinely something I would go back and listen to. So kudos to the production team. Crotch shots, another great crotch shot from Phil there. Kudos to the production team. This is something I actively want to listen to versus
well, that's great.
To reveal people. You know, if they have JTY on there, you would listen to him. You listen to
I would 100% listen. Something I do want to know is in that set design there, odds that those are limited edition Games Workshop Black Library books versus just random old-timey books that they found at a flea market.
I think that they're just old-timey books that they found. That's what I'm going to say.
Almost 100%.
Real
they're
books
just
at the end.
Literal decoration.
I think so.
Probably some good treaties on phrenology back there.
Next to Kirby's How to Market Well. Yeah.
The Algerian edition of Mein Kampf. Just some real...
Just normal books to have nuggets. In a business. Yeah, in a business. That's what it is. His hair looks impossibly soft. Oh, wow. Now, this is big. This is new. A new terrain feature. This probably isn't going to wow you much, but it's quite cool. It's nice.
I mean, I love the Age of Sigmar terrain pieces for sure. They're always cool.
Maybe we're going to see some sort of fighting over Nexus sort of like deal in the future. It'll be fun.
Apparently, the Chaos person on the Demonic Mount is a lady.
Oh, really? A Chaos lady?
I believe that's what I heard Phil say. Oh, we've got a throw to the camera.
Oh. This is great.
Back to this guy. Nice sock game.
That's what you want from Warhammer Reveal, a sock game. Who's he marketing this to? Like, okay, so if this is the...
I like the LED sticks.
Is this going to be the trailer?
The entire budget. Oh, here we go.
No, it's not. This is just some Hype Secunda stuff. Oh, wait, is this Necromunda?
One could only hope.
It is Necromunda. No. Dark Mechanicum? Necronomicon Uh-oh. Horus Heresy.
Uh-oh.
Oh, shit. The Horus Heresy.
What are Cogs wearing?
The Lisan al-Ghaib. That meant nothing to
Thing
you.
In Dark Ganymede.
Val's the only person in the world who hasn't seen Dune. So.
Yeah. No. Yeah, just... And I'm now 0 for 2 on Dunes.
I'm going to make you watch it. That's what it is.
What? What's going on with the presenters? Are they just like walking out to use the bathroom and just getting kidnapped one by one? And so they just have to keep like...
Oh, get you. Here we go. The dwarven.
Oh.
Oh, here we go. Grudges will be settled. Oh, boy. Okay, anything new?
Unlikely.
Unlikely? Wait, that looks new, buddy. Dude.
What was there? No, that is a very old axe... fact.
That's... Wait, are they bringing back the axe chucker?
Yeah, the troll hewer or something.
They bring
it
back Bugman on a pony from the
40s. Of course they are. Oh, wow. That is from the 1980s.
Yikes. These are old.
I mean, Slayer, Army of Infamy confirmed.
Oh, we have undoubtedly. We have a new.
He might be fresh.
He
that
is
might
new.
Be a Forge World resin. Yeah, look at that.
Okay, new dwarf on shield bearers. Oh boy, new dwarf on shield bearers, and what looks mm-hmm. to be
just a little peak though.
Oh really?
Forge your own path.
Yeah, that's so good, and that's the Fire Slayer leader. I know his name. It's just very. It's 3:30 here. Oh shit! It's JTY and Dan. JTY and Dan.
JTY got to be on the right there. The dour looking motherfucker.
That is JTY. JTY yet to crack a smile in 2024. There's a running bet in Specialist Design Studio if he will smile.
Safe money is still safe. This is my overenthusiastic emotion interpreter, Dan.
Yeah, look at JTY's rage that Dan is excited about the project. Like when you cut back, how do you feel about these old sculpts cut return in? These are
middle tier old sculpts. These are like. Storm of Chaos era, so it's still not like old hammer.
I've never seen the axe chucker in my life. Didn't know that existed.
I wonder if they remastered. I wonder if it's remastered or if it's just a made to order. Like, I guess it probably is remastered.
The pony and the donkey, the pony and the cart does not look remastered. It's Dan. It's Dan and JTY. I can't believe they've done the dirty on Jonathan. And
yeah, look at that shell collar.
It's JTY. Don't write Jonathan on here. How dare you?
I like that in the interview, the written interviews, he's been JTY.
Yeah. But the TV department have done him dirty. We've got less crotch in this? I don't know. A lot of crotch.
I'm just waiting to hear him say something. This is exactly the person who I want
is,
to see.
My dream is he says zero. My dream is he says zero in the entire interview. He just stares.
He is mean. I believe they call this the mean mug. He is mean mugging right now.
Look how furious
he is.
Oh, he
didn't like that.
He did not like that. Dan, shut up. Dan.
If you had like a police like artist draw up the description of a Warhammer fantasy player, you might get JTY. Like, just give me a rough approximation of who plays Warhammer fantasy. It's JTY. This man has been waiting for this day. And now it's successful, and he doesn't know what to do about it.
Yeah, JTY is like, by the way, I just released like 19 armies of rules, an entire rule book, and much to the most insane applause the world over, can I not do an interview? And they're like, no, sit there.
Don't make me talk to Nick Boyden.
Yeah. That was his only request. His only request. I don't want the guy that leans in or the guy in the shorts. I don't want any of that business. Okay, we got a new, this is Ungrim,
oh, he's
right?
He's talking. He's sure. He's certainly talking right now.
Okay.
Whomever is speaking is very disinterested.
Okay. Well, this
is a very breathy and uninterested.
Isn't this Ungrim? Isn't this Ungrim?
Look at that guy. No, Ungrim's got he's got like a dragon on him and stuff. There
but this would be young. Would this not be young Ungrim? Would it be his dad?
Could be his dad.
Yeah, could be his dad.
Sorry, I'm transfixed by the sound of his voice.
JTY finally speaks the first time.
Oh, he's going.
Bowels King has spoken. Right now. Okay, Yuggrim, that's his name.
He's dead.
Yuggrim Iron Fist. Yeah.
Yuggrim.
I'm so hyped for Yuggrim to be out. I'm stonks because I love the dwarfs. I think all of this is great. Even though I've been printing some Highland Miniatures dwarfs, I think they're excellent.
They are excellent.
Just as good as these guys. Pretty spicy.
Probably better, in fact.
Yeah.
I mean, the have you seen the Highland Gyrocopter?
Oh yeah, it's really the balloon.
Yeah, the balloon.
Yeah, I've got like six balloons.
Yeah, they're sweet.
That's so sweet.
JTY doesn't downscale. Sorry, someone's asking what scale you print your Highland dwarfs. He doesn't downscale. I did 85% personally.
I didn't. I want to be bigger in all situations. I'm overcompensating. Mm-hmm. That's what I'm doing. If I was presenting, I'd be leaning in as well. That's what I'd be doing. Aggressively leaning in. Yeah.
Did you want to loosen up? I'm almost seeing a warmth crept in. Okay, I'm pausing.
The new dwarf lord on Shield Bearers looks stunning. I'm just going
to
say
it. Is there
now
a third shield bearer back there? Did they add a third leg to the stool?
A third lad? I would hope not.
Is there a third lad?
I've always respected both of the two lads holding up the king. It's a lot of responsibility. Like, it's a lot of effort.
JTY just burst into the sculpting room and was like, "Right, this doesn't make any sense." made him out a third guy.
I don't know if you know how hard Dan is working, but he can't support me. And he's only one. I need three Dens. That's what I need. Then also he would be the guy at the back, and as being pointed out by the chat, he would be getting a lot of dwarf farts in his direction,
mm-hmm.
I think.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I feel like a lot of, as mentioned earlier, a lot of cabbage, I think, probably in the dwarf diet. A lot of root vegetables.
Can we talk about just the sheer volume of effort that they've actually put into this live stream compared to where it used to be, right?
Well, they have an editor, for one thing, so that's something.
They hired a guy.
Yep, there's someone who's had to coordinate schedules and do this all in advance. The rotating cast of interviewers is funny to me, though. I think we're not going to see Beatles' haircut again. He's going to vanish after this one, and it'll be someone new.
Yes, that's nice. Or maybe they're more interested in it. Maybe Classic GW, they don't want anyone to be the lead presenter. Because Eddie's gone. This is huge for reveal fans. People who love the reveals. This is mm-hmm. RIP Eddie. This is a refresh. Maybe this was a collaborative effort. They all got together. This shot is sending me. I cannot. This feels completely superfluous. I don't need this. What, like, also he's like, where's Eddie? Yeah. What do I do now Eddie's not here? Because I don't know stuff. So,
well, he's maybe reading off a teleprompter. Perhaps I jinxed it a little bit.
Okay, I'm not really sure what this is. Ooh. Okay, so old world news. Oh, you're hype, right?
We're in 40k. Yeah, we got a new dwarf thing. Also looked like a plastic kit, maybe, I hope, please God.
Is that new Gene Steelers?
We got some Gene Steelers.
This is huge for me, personally. Huge for me, personally. This will be immediately. And then Votann, but they've got suit jackets. Oh, my God. Everything about this.
I like those guys.
Don't give me any terrain. Let me just buy the box. The Jaeger Bombcast. Oh, my God. These are amazing. These are great minis.
They've named something a Jaeger Bomb? Who let that happen?
A Jaeger Bomb.
they named it a Jaeger. You don't know what a Jaeger Bomb is?
I know what a Jaeger Bomb is. I've sold a lot of Jaeger Bombs in my life. We're back. Elliot's also great. I don't know, Tom. Tom, you seem like a real one.
A lot of great sweaters. Is it chilly in Nottingham this time of year?
Not for Simon.
They actually have the minis on the table for Kill Team. Look at this.
Elliot, interestingly, also previously in the events team, there's actually a direct through line to working in the events team and becoming a rules writer at Games Workshop.
Fascinating.
Like it was for a while the process of getting into. Also, if you worked in the Forge World store at Games Workshop, eventually you normally would get hired into SDS downstairs. Pretty fun. So people would intentionally get jobs in the different sections of the company, trying to work into the next section of the company.
That's funny that those would be the feeders. Well, depends because team.
If you knew the rules, guys, how would you know what was happening? Because you don't look on the internet, because obviously that's a hellhole.
No, you just go and talk to the
events team, and they'll be like, oh, one guy bought a stomper once, and they'll be like, was it good? They're like,
maybe two points. We're going to double it again.
Exactly. Like, that's where they got all of their data from. And then they just hired those people because they came friends. Anyway, we should talk about the minis. Great stuff. I would say, I'm going to say this now. As long as it's reasonably priced, this is an immediate purchase for me.
I'm pretty sure the Gene Stealer cults are not, for the most part, new minis.
Those are the Monopose
original Gene Stealer cult FOMO box board game thing for the Patriarch and the Magus and stuff. I'm not sure about the Acolytes, though.
You're right. There's like a three character kit bundle that's in there and another kit. But it looks like it comes with terrain, which is really sad for me. I'm not that excited about that. But I do like the Acolytes. I think the Acolytes are great, and then the Votan stuff's great. And the reason, as someone who doesn't actively currently play 40k and definitely doesn't play Kill Team, I just think the minis are everything, especially for a Necromunda fan, which I am. This is perfect. You could see all of this in Necromunda. I think it looks great. Really good
stuff.
Fair. Really good stuff. Not really super keen on Kill Team. I actually weirdly was watching a Kill Team battle report today. Of all things.
Why?
Well,
you must have been delirious.
Well, I am delirious. I'm very sick. That probably explains everything. But I was watching Shatterpoint one, and it rolled into a Kill Team one, and I couldn't bother to change it, which is how I assume most battle reports get their views. How I assume they get so that's what they do.
That's how we get most of our viewers, actually. I hate these guys. I can't be bothered.
What's
All
wrong?
Right.
You don't like these
I'll
guys?
Just hang in here. I was saying that's how we get most of our viewers. Just incredibly the chat is just filled with lethargic people who can't even just get their thumb up to the next. No,
I'd like you to know we've only seen two books so far, but a shit ton of minis.
Have we seen a shit ton of minis? Because I've counted. We had the Lord. It's basically one Chaos Lord for 40k, one Chaos Lord for Age of Sigmar.
Two teams for Warcry.
Basically a dozen for Warcry. Actually, if you hadn't cut me off while I was adding it up, I would be basically bang on right now, quite frankly.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Sorry, I apologize for cutting you off. I apologize.
Although I did say no books and no minis for Age of Sigmar, so obviously one book, one mini for Age of Sigmar. I forgot about Dawnbringers.
Did they talk about a book for Old World? No, they just showed the minis.
They just said, minis. Excuse me. Sorry. I apologize. I'm engaged. I'm totally involved and interested in everything else that's going to be shown for the rest of the night. I don't like that they haven't shown the minis again so that we can tell whether or not the Brew Bros are new or not. I assume they are because they always have to have, like, they need to have a sniper bro and they need to have, like, a satchel bomb guy because the skill team.
I mean,
and then they'll change the...
Age of Sigmar eats so well because it has two games that it releases minis for. Like, Kill Team, like, gets these... 40k gets extra models via Kill Team, right? Which is great.
Yes.
But in Sigmar, almost doubles up.
Well, yeah, because... Well, I mean, usually they use Kill Team as a way of, like, refreshing, like, old... Like, the Scouts went into Kill Team. The Striking Scorpions went to Kill Team. As opposed to just releasing them properly. But, you know... New York Commandos, which are some of my favorite new models ever. I actually bought those, and they're just in a box somewhere. But I have them, because I love them so much.
And can you use those Commandos in 40K?
If I was walking into a Games Workshop, and I was like, I'm mini curious, I want to play a miniatures game, I think there's no doubt in my mind I'd play Kill Team. I think I would look at Kill Team and be like, that looks sick.
Coming soon from me, a video about how Skirmish Games is a game we should all be playing. It's just a fact.
Oh, 100%. It only makes sense. But we're all, like, so, you know, pot committed at this point, you know. But, I mean, if I was starting, man, yeah, the Skirmish Games. Hell, Underworlds. Yeah, these guys, are they different?
They are different.
Did we confirm they are different?
They are different, yeah.
I guess the old ones were Cadians. Yeah, the old ones were Cadians. Yeah, they would have had to have gotten a refresh. I wonder if it's the same way as it used to be. If it's just the Cadians with a head swap kit.
I think they look great. Like, I'm a fan, is what I'm going to say. I think they look really, really good. not too dissimilar to the kits we've seen released previously, to be honest. So that's
TBH.
Fair.
TBH.
TBH.
Well, like the old Brood Brothers were just like, they're just like the chunky Cadians with a sprue. So maybe that's what these guys are. But that is the old Patriot. That's the Patriarch from before. For sure.
Do you know what? These are militarized gene sealers. So like they are like the new Imperial Guard armor. New Astra Militarum armor. Yeah, the Brood Brothers. But like they actually, yeah, you're right, 100%. Sorry. But they look really, you know, it's quite a departure. Wonder if we'll
see more. Also, let's just call this out. We're watching right now a reveal for Gene Stealer Cults versus Squats. Like
it's
8 years ago, this is a wet dream. You know, this is something that like people would had hoped for so long. And now it's, who cares? Is that even a new one?
I mean, I care. I think they're great, but yeah, you're right. Like, you're such a good point. Yeah, good point.
I also think they missed an opportunity to have one tall, squat guy, and it was revealed just like the Iron Maiden dude in the Underworld's team to just be actually two squats on each other's shoulders because they're wearing trench coats. Real missed opportunity to have one tall squat. But it's two guys in a trench.
That's Age of Sigmar 4, don't forget. Silly and not silly. Okay. That's not 40K. That's 40K 11th is silly and not silly. Okay. this is good that they're getting the designers on to talk, although not that fun.
I mean,
they're
going on.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, I'm engaged. I'm not yawning actively. It's not
yawning.
No, I'm not. That was not a yawn. That was not a yawn. Repeatedly. Into the microphone. I'll mute the next one at least.
Okay.
What would you call a tall squat? A twat? Yeah, probably. Good one, Chad.
God, so people are talking about that there is a lot of crotch. Elliot is absolutely manspreading for that camera. That is.
I mean, he's just giving the camera what it wants. That's, you know.
Like, I mean, Elliot's a looker. Let's be real.
I mean, you know, they're. Not wearing shorts in the wintertime. So, I mean, they got that going for them.
Yeah, Simon runs immediately. Hot. That's all I can think. Simon runs so warm.
I mean, there is a faraway look in the person on the right now, just thinking about some stuff that he's been through.
Yeah.
How did his career wind up where it is right now?
He's like, I wish I didn't have to write this in 3 days. Like, if they could have just given me a week, that would have been so good. Okay. Straight to Jamie Oliver.
Oh, this is a big throw. Big throw here.
Oh, why? Why is it a big throw?
Well, no, it's like a big throw to the camera. They keep leaning in and like really staring down the camera. It's a big throw to the camera.
Oh,
what is this? Oh, Necromunda.
Oh, they've transitioned into Necromunda. Oh, wait, is that it? Was there a bunch of minis?
Yeah, it's just a tease. Just a tease. Just the tip.
Just
and
the tip.
And now back to Jamie Oliver.
No, not Jamie Oliver. We've got Simon and Alex, who honestly, this is the buddy cop movie I want from Games Workshop.
I mean, they seem more fun.
Yeah. These are great guys. They're having a great time. What is this? I can't believe they wrote X. Gross. Just write Twitter.
I mean,
he's back.
I could definitely see the Games Workshop account having the Twitter blue profile for sure.
I think I'm going to have to put the audio up for this.
One more thing to show you.
Here we go. Okay. I'm going to watch this. Oh, boy.
Let's do it.
Let's go chat. The trailer.
Sigmar lied.
Cinematic. It's a Zangor.
Mm. Oh, yeah.
This is some PlayStation 2 graphics we got going.
I was going to say, this looks about as good as Clone Wars.
Sigmar told us we were chosen.
I'm back.
Oh, that's good.
Holy gosh.
To be reforged as his weapons.
He's huge.
Whoa, this is cool.
I mean, this is hard to mock in any way, shape, or form. It's pretty cool as hell.
It's just a shame that the armor looks so bad.
Sons and daughters of the Storm God.
Well, they spend a little bit more on that face.
We're going back to the realm of fire, boys. We're going back to the realm of fire. Let's leave Gurr behind. Okay. All right.
Okay.
Okay. This is looking good.
I mean, it looks like cool shit.
Oh, my heart. Oh, shit. A necroquake.
I mean, that seems Ratman-like.
Yeah, Skaven at Age of Sigmar 4 box. Ooh.
Oh, very Ratman, yes, yes.
Sound the bells! Quick, rats. the bells will work. Let's go.
Why does it have to be rats?
Oh, a new Stormcast, bro. That's really PlayStation 2. Just gonna say it. Yeah. Oh, no. That is not the best. Let's be honest.
I love how the Stormcast swing those gigantic axes like they're made of styrofoam.
Yeah, they don't have any realism to them, do they? New prosecutors. We've been confirmed new prosecutor kits. Oh, here's the leaked machine that we saw as a sprue.
Oh, yeah. You like rattling guns? How about a gigantic rattling gun? I don't mind.
Okay, is this guy a griffin? It looks like a new griffhound.
Oh, tomahawk chop.
Get
out of here. Ooh.
Oh.
I was her all along. The true cost of this honor. But now the Skaven are just there. All that will remain of me is an echo. Lost to the storm. But until that day, I fight.
Okay, so it looks like...
Man, those are some pretty poorly built rat condos, if I must say. They need to...
Yeah, and let me tell you, the graphics of those Stormcast look yikesy. But I'm very, very pumped. It's not quite the same as the quality of the one that we saw for Horus Heresy, or the same as we saw as quality for 40K. So much cheaper. In fact, it looks directly, because there has been a game that's been out recently. We got all game three cinematics. Big hitters.
Who's Ben?
Ben is the Stu Black of Age of Sigmar. Ben's had a bit of a checkered history, unfortunately, in the tournament scene. As the lead developer for Age of Sigmar, has on multiple occasions taken a army that has been released that weekend as the person who knows what's in the book, and then has won an event with it. And
better late than never to play test something, okay? Like,
yeah.
He's just doing a favor.
Yeah, and then won the event. This happened three times, I think. And then I think it got literally told, stop doing that. So,
please stop doing that.
Please stop doing that, yeah. But that's just a fun little side thing. So Stormcast, exciting. It looks like they're really trying to lean into the idea that eventually, like, they'll lose the soul of the Stormcast. And so we thought maybe that's what they'd be leaning into in this edition, but maybe we'll see them leaning into it, like, you know, they're starting that storyline at the beginning of 4th Ed leading into 5th Ed, and they'll just let Skaven do a lot of the work for them early, which I think is fair, because Skaven's a great lot of story to push through, like, long term, which I think is quite fun. We've seen some resculpts of some different minis, and what's quite fun for them as a company that sells stuff is because of the reforging process of Stormcast, eventually you have to have a new version of a Stormcast, kind of. Like, they die, they go back to Azir, they get reforged, and eventually they can be like, look, you know, like, we've given them a new hammer when they got reforged, or we gave them a new armor when they got reforged. You know what I mean? So they have a process of recycling units infinitely. When they came up with that, they must have thought that they were like, they'd nailed it. And then they
were geniuses.
Yeah, they were like, okay, but what about gold blocky armor? Which is pretty yikesy. So, but yeah, pretty fun. pretty fun. So I'm excited. I think it's looking really cool. It's nice to get a trailer. That trailer definitely deserves its own deep dive because there's loads of stuff you can take out for that. The new units that you're going to see, that looks like the new Ra'uga we just saw. Mm-hmm. We're going to see new Jezails because they've shown off Jezails there. So like they're definitely nodded towards loads of the new kits that we're going to see be released. But they haven't yet. Last year at Adepticon, they said if they were going to index the game, and that's the kind of spicy news we're all waiting for right now.
I mean, that's got to be assured, no? Like, how long has it been? Has Age of Sigmar ever truly reset?
No, never. Well, not really, eh? It took until about 3 years ago till we actually had a book for every army. Like, it was a long time coming. Some armies languished for 6-7 years before they ever even got, like, a book, finally. Which is kind of interesting.
Yeah, so, like, it's... Yeah, that's... Yeah, okay. Because, yeah, everything was sort of combined. Well, I guess they had the free... Like, the very beginning, everything was free online. Mm. So I guess, actually, Age of Sigmar was the first true, like, index experiment that they'd done.
Mm. Yeah, that was, yes.
But I guess it's been it. And it, what are we 9 years of Hordes, Sigmar at this point?
Ravening Hordes was the first index, was it not?
Ravening Hordes was sixth edition fantasy. Unless they use that name again, that's possible.
No, wasn't there like a reset in Warhammer Fantasy Battle at some point? I thought.
Yeah, Ravening Hordes. That was sixth edition.
Okay, that was our first index edition, I guess, ever in Warhammer.
Before that, the third edition 40K would have been a full reset.
Okay.
But that was in the rule book.
Oh, okay. All right. So yeah. I guess we do AOS 1, 8th edition is really what we're talking about. Yeah, it looks like they're talking about on screen. We got some new, what looks to be like Annihilators. What was the, not the 9th edition box set where they had the Space Marines with the shield, the big shield and a sword? They were a new unit type.
Yeah.
So it looks like we're getting those for Age of Sigmar now. Just a big shield, bro, and an upgrade. Just more Stormcast, really. Which is, honestly, just more of the same, and like not that different. A new Stormcast on a Griffin is great, or not Griffin, Griff Charge is what it looks like. But like,
yeah,
the last release was Stormcast on Dragons. Very different. I think this is not
pretty
quite...
Look at those. There's some really good Dragonheart style dragons, as far as I'm concerned.
Yeah, but I don't think
they
this
all
is...
talk like Sean Connery.
Sean Connery. Do you think this is a big deal? A ground up rules rewrite. Index Hammer confirmed. Okay, it's been confirmed by the rules designers that it isn't.
It's
Index
a rewrite.
Hammer. It's a rewrite, ladies and gentlemen. I called it.
Ground up or. Are they thinking that they'll take it to 11, though?
Oh, they're going to turn... Bro, Phil's in the room. If you don't turn things up to 11 when Phil's in the room, you're not trying, right? So a ground-up rules rewrite. This is where Matt will argue that they had to do it because of circumstances which they created. My favorite situation is when they all get in a room together and they're like, what's happening? They're like, we're resetting the game. Why? Oh, it's just become a shit show, hasn't it? Like, we could barely handle it. And you're like, how did it get like this? Like, we know, man. Like, someone just kept releasing books and rules for the game. And it's you. You did it. You're the problem.
You did this.
You're the problem. Yeah. You did this.
Meanwhile, JT Wise just... sitting on the crapper reading a newspaper, because I bet you he reads the newspaper.
Yeah.
And he's just like, it's all going right past him, because you know what? He's already reset his game. He's all good to go, baby.
Yeah. No weapon ranges in the game. 3-inch range for all. That's a big change in Age of Sigmar.
Big
change. For the whole of Age of Sigmar 3, some of the units just have not been able to strike long enough. It took them 2.5 years to be like, add an inch to some weapon ranges. Like the easiest update. They could have done it in 8 minutes, like 3 years ago.
You see, Rob, you've got to send it to the translators. And it takes a lot of time, you know? Yeah. Like, it takes time. You can't just write a new PDF in a word processor, okay? Google Translate.
How about slick or not slick for Age of Sigmar 4? Ready for that?
I like silly or not silly. That is my personal favorite. I think that's a good t-shirt, quite frankly.
Yeah, yeah. It's pretty wild to also showcase and tell people that they're releasing a brand new game with a rules write with a book that they just announced yet to come out and also a box set still to come out in this release cycle.
There's still a FOMO box before Age of Sigmar 4?
Yeah, the Dark Oath book. Dark Oath box, yeah.
And it's got a rule book in it for a dead game?
Yeah.
Yeah, have we seen this? Normally, Adepticon, like, when it's 40K's release cycle, we would have seen the last, like, the last 40K thing is usually, like, early, I guess, what, their Q3? Like, early Q3 for them? And then Adepticon would be like, all right, here's the big, you know, looking forward to Q1 announcement, usually 40K or whatever. But they've already bilked everybody. Like, they've released, you know, Fulgrim, and like they've released the Cadians, like they did like the Guard as they did last time. Like, you don't usually see them advertising or hyping literally like obsolete merch at the same time as the new thing. Like, that's how are you even selling that book?
I thought about this. I was like, oh, because when I did make my index video, I did say, oh, it's not much of a cash windfall at the beginning of the game. They really do this to get new people. Like, a rules reset is a feature, not a bug of their games. They do that to, like, bring new audiences in. But then I forgot that they did those cards that were immediately out of date, the unit cards, and they must have sold millions of sets of those cards.
Just lots of them, yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Just absolutely huge. This is crazy. There's a new combat patrol mode. Those combat patrol tourneys are huge right now. So I'm glad about that. That's been a major feature of the 40K scene has been the combat patrol tournaments.
Mm-hmm.
Let me know in the comments the ones you've enjoyed and have been to.
I wonder why they do that. Like, what? Why not just make a stronger 10, you know, rather than all of these little games, you know, like just make a stronger 10.
How do you
maybe
mean?
Even bring it up to 11.
Oh,
I just mean like the combat patrol thing. Like, it's just like, why spend time on that at all?
Because most of the reason people buy stuff for Warhammer is speculative. Like, you.
Yeah, maybe I'd like to do that. Yeah, sure.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Like, oh, I'll do combat patrol. I'll buy the starter box. That's my justification. Never build or paint it next time. No, I will do combat patrol this time. I'll just buy that box, which more interests me now.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But I mean, I don't think there's a lot of that kind of rationalizing going on for like Dawnbringers, for example.
No,
Dawnbringers book six. Like, book six, that's greedy as fuck. Six?
Six.
Six books.
Six books. They're all 30 quid each.
The end times were five. There were five end times books, guys.
If I could compare the sheer dearth of information that's in a Dawnbringers book versus an End Times book. Although the End Times did literally destroy an entire game franchise that had been existed for 30 years, so, you know, like...
I mean, I'm glad they put some effort into it.
Yeah, nice. At least they didn't... They weren't like, it's over, boys. They were like, here are five limited edition massive books.
Chonkers.
And then screw you.
Yes.
Which they released knowing... They were like, we're going to destroy your game. Here's a limited edition book. The brass cojones on those guys is actually... Have you ever like sat down and thought about the sheer power of that?
Power of what?
To sit down and be like, all right, boys, we're in a boardroom, right? This is my pitch. We're in a boardroom. All right, boys, we're going to destroy this game. We're going to do a new game. All right, cool. But this is my idea. I'm going to do a series of different books which cost a load of money. Before mm-hmm. we destroy it, which will invalidate everything. What do you think?
Yes, making those books useless. And not only that, but we're going to do that every time.
This will now be the like, format. This will now be
every,
the format.
From now on, we're going to do that. Every 3 years, we're going to spend a year releasing an obsolete set of books. And that will herald the new edition, but no one will realize that for some reason, even though we do it every 3 years. I can almost name them all. Like, there was, wow, that's great. Even 7th edition 40K ended with that, with the Magnus versus Gilliman story arc that begat the Yanari came out of that. And then you had Psychic Awakening. Did 9th edition? Maybe 9th edition 40K didn't do that. I don't remember a campaign book series for 9th edition 40K. Obviously, you had the End Times. You've had Dawnbringers.
By the
was
way,
there, was at the end of 2nd edition, was there one of these things?
For the end of 2nd edition, yes, it was called Broken Realms.
Gathering Storm was Broken the Realms. End of 7th edition.
Broken Realms for Broken Realms. AOS. By the way, pretty massive news. Young Ungrim is confirmed. So the Slayer King is the mini. So it's Young Grim.
Huh.
You're the first. Listen, get the picture, type Young Grim underneath it, bang on those Facebook groups. You're the first with a meme, buddy. First with a meme.
Also, turn off protected searching mode and just type in Young Grim into Google search. See what happens. There's some really like the dwarves got some love here. By the way, there is an official royal fart sniffer pulling up the rear of that shield.
Oh, is there? Third shield bearer confirmed.
Yeah.
Third shield bearer confirmed. Okay, this is huge. Apparently the guys are dropping a load of hot information.
It's plastic. It is a plastic Lord Shield Bearer guy.
Okay, this is plastic. The old release. Okay, that's pretty exciting. That's pretty exciting.
Also, their battalion box is way better than the Orc one. Jerks.
I mean, the dwarfs, they're way better. That's just...
They got way better.
I've decided I'm standing for dwarfs really hard in Old World. That's what I'm doing. I'm standing. I know the traditional thing is to hate on dwarfs and dwarf players as an Old World guy, but I'm not doing it. I refuse. I refuse to do it anymore.
Yeah, we got like 32 dwarf warriors, and then it looks like another what do we got here? 3, 6, 8. Yeah, and then another 32 quarrelers/thunderers, and then 2 gyros.
Whoa.
It's pretty good. I don't like how these boxes don't come with any characters now though. That's kind of weird.
Yeah,
this guy on Shieldbearer is great. He's great. He's great.
So that looks like it's the end of the reveal. They dropped a bunch of information in that little chat about Age of Sigmar 4 as well. Like the things that
you might want to go actually listen to it.
Yeah, well, I'll do that on another show. That'll definitely be another video. Chat have dropped some hot information, all war scrolls are going to fit on a single-sided card. Simple, not simpler. Not fun, but funner. You know, classic stuff. It looks like universal special rules are in. Go on.
No, I mean, like, it's very popular, the universal special rules.
Very popular. Very popular. Universal special rules are in. It looks like weapon profiles are a thing. Color-coded phase rules, apparently. That sounds really interesting. I like how they were like, okay, so we've had this game out for 3 years, Age of Sigmar. Things happen in the hero phase. Yeah, we have said there's a beginning. There's also a start of the beginning and an end of the beginning. Start of the middle.
Right.
But interestingly, there's stuff that happens at the end but before the end. How can we solve this? Well, if we color code it, that'll really solve this problem.
That'll do it.
That'll do it. All right. Okay. thanks, buddy. Have you had a good time? What did you think? Let's do a quick TLDR. They've set that presentation up a lot.
Well, I mean, in fairness, our method of reviewing the presentation, we can't hear most of the presentation. So, I mean, it is tough to judge exactly what was said. Nick Boynton looked like he made a few good points, just judging. I have no idea, man. Like, 40K was a letdown, but that's fine. It's not their year. Old World looks great. I mean, like, yeah, the Dwarf reveal looks fantastic. And I'm really excited for Age of Sigmar to see where they take things. Of course, I'm just particularly interested to see what kind of cool new rats are going to come out.
They are very cool. I think we've seen, like, I think we'll just see a range refresh, to be honest. You're right, though. Normally when we do a React stream, it's because they're showing the mini on the screen for a significant portion of time. And then there's some inane chatter in the background. And it sounds like that they've removed the inane chatter, got some really good conversation, but then haven't kept the minis on the screen. So right. we lost the thing that I think most people really enjoyed, which is just a clean shot of the minis. And then we got actual good content and information from creators, which is great. So
fantastic.
Like, so close, boys. Like, maybe it's like the triangle. You can only have one of the two of the three.
Somewhere in that Venn diagram in the middle is a perfect Warhammer preview. Yeah. And maybe we'll get there. Maybe we'll get there. I for one, am looking forward to going to sleep, listening to the dulcet tones of one JTY and other Danny. It's going to be great.
In before, you've accidentally clipped a soundboard clip of JTY saying something which we use forever then.
That's a very good point. I guess I can't go to bed. I'm going to have to do that near my soundboard. That's fine. I'll do this.
Yeah, I think we need to end this stream with a thank you to the chat and thank you to everyone who watched us back. Also, we got a shout out. Pull one out. RIP the Eddie streams. Seems like we've moved away Eddie. From that now. It's gone. It's not part of our process anymore, which is sad. So
well, looks like Phil Kelly though just slithered right in there and just filled that void. He's owning it, so it's all good.
Phil Kelly was like, "Oh, Eddie is no longer dominating the space. Time for me to dominate the whole couch."
Phil Kelly abhors a vacuum. That's what they say.
Anyway, obviously, we'll do more of a deep dive on loads of these things. Me and Val will definitely talk about the Dwarf release in another video. I'm going to break down the Age of Sigmar 4 changes in information in another video as well. So if you've enjoyed it, then do check those out. Thank you to everyone who joined us live. It's 4:15 in the morning here in the UK, so I'm going to get to bed. But you've all been great. Loads of love. See you soon. Goodbye.